Hello, learners. Welcome to this wonderful world of English language classroom. Here we learn English language as fun. We, you, your friends and I, together will learn various aspects and components of English language with an engagement with ideas and use language. Are you ready? Let's move on to learn the language better. Fine. Do you know what are we doing to learn today? How would you know? Obviously, how would you know? I am going to tell you now. We will learn to write a notice in English language. Yes, notice writing. You may have learnt this from class 6th onwards. Great. We will now discuss how to write a notice effectively. Ready? Ready, get set and go. Wow, you are all great learners. Let's see our objectives for this lesson on notice writing. Fine, here are some of the important objectives. After going through this writing lesson, you will be able to, number one, understand the purposes of writing a notice. Two, think, reflect, and gather ideas for writing a notice. Point number three, organize ideas, information to write a notice for an occasion. Number four, write the notice with all information and ideas required. And number five, edit and improve upon the notice written and write the final draft. Now, what do we do while writing a notice? Let's do one writing task by undergoing different stages of writing. Let's first look at a notice being displayed. The first title is City Hockey Club, Shri Aurobindo Mark, Phulpur. Then it says notice. And then the final title is Friendly Hockey Match. Now the body of the notice starts with, residents of Phulpur are informed that City Hockey Club is organizing a friendly exhibition match between elder and youth hockey teams on 28th of March 2018 at 4 p.m. in the school playground to raise funds for the care of elderly. Interested residents are requested to register their names with the secretary of the club. Tickets are available in the panchayat office. And the last line says, all are welcome. And if you see, the ending is on the left-hand side and it ends with Phulpur, Kakari, March 16th to 2018. President, as you read, look at the notice and see what it contains. We may ask. Now, these are a set of questions we can always think and do our notice with. For example, the first question is, what is the purpose of the notice? Second question is, what is the event for which the notice is written? To whom the notice is addressed to? That was question number three. We move on to question number four, which says, when is the event taking place? And question number five, what is expected of the people who read the notice? We still continue with question number six. Who gives the notice? Question number seven. What is the format of the notice? Now, let me ask you the questions again and go one by one. And now I will give you time to think and answer. All set? We can do it together. Good? So let's start. My question one is, what is the purpose of the notice? So the answer is, the notice is for the friendly hockey match between the elder and youth team of, yes, you got it, Phulpur. Now, the second question which I mentioned earlier, what is the event for which the notice is written? Simple answer, the event is the hockey match to be held on, you got it right, 28th March 2018. Now, moving on to the next question. To whom the notice is addressed to? I know the answer is very simple, but still I have to share it with you. It says, the notice is addressed to all the people of Phulpur. Now, going on to the next question. When is the event taking place? Oh, you got it right. On 20th March 2018 at 4 p.m. So the next question is, what is expected of the people who read the notice? So the answer is, the ones interested to register to play and other to watch and enjoy the match. The last question, who gives the notice? It is the president of the club. Now, this is a very important part of notice writing. What is the format of the notice? And we have to understand this. See, it has the name of the club, heading, description of the event. And the description of the event includes what, where, and when, all three W questions. And this importantly is followed by a signature of the notice giver, that is his or her designation, and place, and also date. So I repeat, it has to be followed by the signature of the notice giver, along with his or her designation, place, and date. I hope that it is somewhat clear to you. The format is a very important component of notice writing. Let's now write the notice task. So please pull up your socks. And the task is the task. You are the secretary of the school health club. Wow, that's a big responsibility. So you are the school health club secretary and your club is planning to organize health checkup camp for all in the village. Wow, doctors from the city hospital will be doing the checkup of people and advising them for better health. Wow, that's a great responsibility. The camp will take place on 7th of April in your school. That is your school playground. And the district magistrate will inaugurate the health checkup camp. So, you write a notice to the people of the village so that they can attend the camp and get their health checked up. You would be doing great social work, I feel. So, we can draft a notice on that. Now, you have got the task of writing the notice. How will you write? Let's try. Let's try by brainstorming ourselves and gathering ideas. Can we ask some questions to gather items and information? Yes, definitely we can. And I see your heads nodding, even though I can't see you physically. Here are the questions. If you remember, we had done some questions when we were discussing how to write a notice. So let me read out the questions. You are to jot down the points and then also what is the purpose of the notice. So first, read the question or the task again and think about the purpose of the question. The purpose is to inform people of the village about the health checkup camp. What is the event for which the notice is written? Remember? Think. So I repeat. What is the event for which the notice is written? Even it is a health checkup camp. Now, remember, to whom the notice is addressed to? All the people of the village. Then, think, when is the event taking place? Yes, you remember the date? It was on 7th April 2018. Now, move on with the next question. What is expected of the people who read the notice? Yes, the people are requested to attend the camp and get their health checked up. Who gives the notice? Remember the last question? Yes, it's the secretary, health club. So, now let's look at what is the format of the notice. Format you have seen already and here it is again for you. The first line says, name of the organization, oblique school, oblique place. And then you write the word notice. And then you write the main event. Now, we come to the body of the notice. Now, if you remember, we've already discussed about the three W's, that is what, when, and when will include date and time, and what is expected of the audience. So, after we complete the body, we have to understand that on the left-hand side, we write place and then date, that is of giving the notice. And on the right-hand side, we write the name of the person giving the notice. And in the second line, which follows, is the designation. For example, secretary / president. Is it fine? Can we move on? I guess so. I get your response. Now, you have gathered ideas and information for writing the notice. Great, fine, very good, well done. I can go on with so many beautiful adjectives for you. But now, let us understand that we have to write a notice yourself. Big responsibility and a challenge. Now, take a look at the information gathered here. Here it is. What is the purpose of the notice? The purpose is to inform people of the village about the health checkup camp. What is the event for which the notice is written? Even if the health checkup camp, to whom the notice is addressed to? All the people of the village, right? So, to whom the notice is addressed to? It is addressed to all the people of the village. When is the event taking place? It's taking place on 7th of April, 2018. What is expected of the people who read the notice? People are requested to attend the camp and get their health checked up. Next, who gives the notice? The secretary, health club. What is the format of the notice? The format you have seen, and here it is, right in front of you on the display. Take some time to write the notice. I will show the complete notice written by someone like you. Yes, it is very encouraging. So it says, as it is there on the display. So we can all take a sigh of relief. Finally, you must have got it by now. Please note one thing very well. These are some of the points which I am revising. You write anything, be it a notice, letter or report, article or an essay. You should ensure there is no error in your writing. You write with complete self-confidence and surety. So when you write a notice, you write the first draft. The first draft is important. And then you develop the first write-up into final notice. We have seen process approach to writing in our previous classes. You may go back and look at them. I hope you do so, because that will help you to rebuild and write this notice well. Even though I don't want to leave this classroom and go, but before we close this session or lesson, I would like to give you two tasks of, you guessed it right, notice writing. I believe you will do them. Cross your heart, you will do them. Great. So here is the task. I want you to listen carefully. As the captain of the school sports committee, write a notice to all students of classes 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th to register for the inter-school sports meet for various events. The meet will be held from May 2nd to 8th in your school. Also inform them that the last date for registration is April 10th. That is task 1. Now, task 2. Ram Rafil is the president of the village panchayat of Karunpur. The panchayat has decided to hold a public bearing of grievances on every second Saturday of the month. Now remember this clause, the grievance is on second Saturday of the month. This has to be mentioned in the notice. Write a notice to the people of the village for Ram Rafil. Mention the time and the place. I hope you will be doing these two notice writing tasks and share with your friends and teachers and exchange your notice writing. And I must thank you for patiently participating in English language classroom. You have been great students. So now we will discuss another topic or aspect of English language to learn language better in the next class. All the very best.